Lucy was 25 when she returned to her homeland after several years away. After graduating from high school, her parents sent their daughter to study in England, where she got a good education at a prestigious university. She grew up in a very wealthy family. Her parents, in spite of their social status and wealth, never boasted about it and were very decent people. The couple rose from the bottom and was a success due to their own persistence. And now, as their daughter grew up and turned into an enchanting, intelligent person, they dreamed that she would find a worthy fiancé in England. But the girl spent more time studying than searching for a life partner. Lucy explained to her parents that her destiny would appear at the right moment, and it was not worth rushing things. But from time to time, her mother introduced her daughter to the candidates for her hand and heart. Lucy was only angry at her parents' intrusive desire to marry her off as soon as possible. Several times, the girl started a romantic relationship, but it did not lead to anything serious. Lucy was not too upset by failures on the love field. After all, she spent most of her free time volunteering, and it was her favorite thing to do. Since her childhood, her kind heart and compassion did not allow her to pass quietly by those in need of help. She participated in various promotions and campaigns to improve the living conditions of poor people. She helped animals abandoned on the street. She donated money to various shelters and help centers. One day, Lucy was walking down the street and suddenly noticed a guy coming out of a store with a bag full of groceries. He walked up to a homeless man and donated his purchases to him. The girl couldn't believe her eyes. It is rare nowadays to see people capable of compassion and ready to help the deprived. The stranger caught Lucy's heart with his nobility. The guy even talked a little about something with the tramp. The girl approached the homeless man and gave him some money. The man was happy and thanked them both. After saying goodbye to the man, the young people walked along the street, discussing volunteering. The man's name was Kevin, and their conversation continued at a nearby cafe. In a cozy place with a cup of coffee, they discussed the activities in which they had participated. Lucy was pleased with his humor and approach to life. She realized that she would like to meet him again, so she said to Kevin about it, and he gladly agreed. Before saying goodbye, Lucy as usual asked for the bill and was going to pay, but Kevin interrupted her, saying he could afford to treat the pretty girl. On the way home and all the next day, the girl's thoughts were occupied only by the charming and amusing Kevin. With his kind heart, he stood out very much from the rest of the guys she had the chance to talk to. Soon, Kevin called Lucy and asked her out on a date. They went to an exhibition of a little-known young artist who donated money from the sale of paintings to charity. The couple could not resist and bought a painting each to contribute to the common cause. Then they took a long walk through the evening city, had coffee in the park, and listened to street musicians. The more Lucy got to know Kevin, the more she was surprised at how similar they seemed. Before, she thought she would never find a guy who could understand her desire to help others and not ridicule her. Kevin happened to sponsor several orphanages and animal shelters, and that alone might have fascinated Lucy. Soon the feelings between them became stronger. Kevin was very attentive and caring, and never ceased to amaze Lucy. More than once he arranged a romantic dinner for her on the roof of a high-rise building, took her to interesting places with stunning nature, got the tickets to her favorite band's concert. Lucy was happy, and decided it was time to introduce him to her parents. And Kevin made a lasting impression on the family with his impeccable appearance and manners. He dressed in a classic suit, and presented his sweetheart and her mother with a bouquet of white roses, and her father with a bottle of high-class whiskey. With a dazzling smile, he introduced himself to his parents, and paid attention to each member of the family throughout the evening. Kevin amazed everyone with his wit and manners, and even played a posh white grand piano in the living room. The father liked the daughter's chosen one very much, and he approved of Lucy's choice. So Kevin and Lucy's relationship reached a new level. She never tired of reminding herself what a wonderful and merciful man she had chosen. In her eyes, Kevin was the most sensitive and wise. Next to her, he was ready to feed every stray kitten on the street and give a large bill to every tramp. It seemed that nothing foretold trouble and only immense happiness lay ahead. But fate had another plan. One day, Lucy was making breakfast and went to open the window to let in some fresh air. She noticed Kevin walking toward her house and wanted to wave to him. But suddenly, she froze in surprise. Behind Kevin walked a poor lame man with a pitiful face. Kevin turned around and said something to him, and then pushed him in the chest. The beggar fell down, and Kevin spat beside him and went as if nothing had happened. Seeing this act, Lucy quickly jumped away from the window so Kevin would not notice her and began to think frantically, what was that all about? What she had seen did not tie in with the image that had formed in her head. When Kevin came to her house, Lucy pretended to have a severe headache and that she would not be able to go anywhere today. When Kevin left, she quickly went to the orphanages, where Kevin was supposedly the main sponsor. But they had never heard of him. Lucy was depressed, but found the strength to meet Kevin. When she told him about her unsuccessful trip to the orphanages, he did not hesitate and began to lie that he had simply mixed up the addresses of all the places he had sponsored. At this point, Lucy could not hold back, because Kevin was lying right to her eyes. She said that she had seen with her own eyes what he had done to a beggar not far from her house. But again, Kevin said without a shadow of doubt that that beggar had tried to steal his purse from his trouser pocket. That is why he pushed the tramp away and explained to him that he didn't respect impudence. Lucy pretended to believe it, because in principle, it could happen. But she decided to check it out. Her friend dressed up as a beggar and made appropriate makeup. Then she waited for Kevin near his house and began to pursue him. The woman asked him to give her alms and explained that she and her children had nothing to eat. To this, Kevin rudely told her to leave him alone and called her a nasty old woman. But Lucy's friend, dressed as a beggar, did not stop and made Kevin so angry that he even took a swing at her. Lucy watched it all from a distance and came up to them just in time. At this very time, the beggar ostentatiously took off her wig and began to wash her makeup. Kevin froze on the spot and realized that he had just been revealed by Lucy. He looked at her fiercely, and Lucy could not stop the tears of disappointment. She waved to the guard she had come with, and in a moment he was there and put Kevin in the car. After a serious conversation, Kevin confessed that he was a con man who specialized in rich brides. He usually scammed lonely ladies of age. He surrounded them with care and attention, inspired interest in himself, and enriched himself at the expense of gullible women. So the guy could afford to live well and not need anything. Kevin had long noticed Lucy, but did not know how to approach her. And when he found out about her interest in helping the disadvantaged, he pulled a stunt with a homeless man. Lucy was very upset and regretted the wasted time and feelings. The girl promised herself that next time she would not be so naive in her choice of a boyfriend. And she would no longer rush headlong into a new relationship. In the meantime, she needed time to come to her senses and get on with her life. If you like the story, subscribe and like it. Have a nice day.